As you can see behind me, these are ubiquitous trees found all over India. They are very drought hardy. Very few animals eat them. The community protects these trees because there is income generated. The communities would look after these trees in India, and these trees have been a part of the Indian landscape from time immemorial. Today, we are not talking about any tamarind tree. We are talking about a tamarind tree that is so special that it has yet to be recorded in the taxonomic tree descriptors. The one that I'm talking about is the red tamarind tree. I first noticed this tree in a temple in Nellakonda in Andhra Pradesh, and that tree is said to be at least 100 years old. Now, such a tree should have been all over India, but the reason why the seeds of this particular tree are never planted is because the temple makes a certain powder from these seeds, and that powder is used as food coloring in the prasad. That is the offering that is given by the temple to its devotees. So we've had a tree that's 100 years old and no seeds of those trees have ever been planted. The tree itself is uniquely special. It has red pulp and it has this wonderful red food coloring that is entirely organic and can be used as a substitute for synthetic food colorings. This red tamarind can be made into pastes, it can be made into jellies, it can be made into jams. And what is more important is, in this Mission Green Earth 2020, this red tamarind has been identified as one of the species that will be planted across India and perhaps even various other parts of the world. In this IWC 2020, history is being created when the dignitaries on the dais are going to plant these red tamarind seeds, perhaps for the first time in many, many decades. It is a very special moment, and I urge you all to join me in giving them a big hand.